Aileen Wuornos, The Damsel of Death by Gisela K. Narrated by Gisela K. About the series. Welcome to the Grizzly Books True Crime book series, where each serial killer featured will be meticulously studied and presented to you as a comprehensive book in a variety of formats, paperback, ebook, and audiobook, as well as a podcast season. While there is an abundance of information available online about each subject, rarely is all the information available in one convenient location. This book series strives to offer you a tell-all, myth-busting, deep-dive experience, where you will learn as much information as one could possibly absorb about each case. This is the fourth book in the series and follows John Wayne Gacy, the Killer Clown, Jeffrey Dahmer, the Milwaukee Monster, and Ted Bundy, the Campus Killer. All the links to the books, podcast, artwork, and more can be found at grizzly-books.com. There are many titles planned for the years ahead. Follow Grizzly Books to stay up to date with all the new releases, special announcements, and other exciting projects. I hope you enjoy reading this book as much as I enjoyed writing it. Stay safe. Gisela K. A poem about Aileen by Gisela K. A somber beginning, a notorious end. Her life was not well spent, although there were some good times. The bowling alley, the mall, those times with her friends, the other kids in the pits, who gave her cigarettes and gum and got her on her way to freedom. She realized then what she was worth, that all she needed was her thumb, her willingness to please, and someone to love. If she had all of the above, she'd be set. So, off she went to get it. But not without a fight. 7 men, 6 corpses, the crooked cops who set her up. Just her luck. Society, the scum. Just look at what everyone else has done. Why would anyone put to death a woman who acted in self-defense? Unless she didn't. Introduction. Aileen Wuornos was many things, but a monster was not one of them. She did not have the inherent evil that we typically see in serial killers, but make no mistake, she was a serial killer. While many women have committed serial murder throughout history, Aileen was the first to be recognized by the FBI as America's first female serial killer because she murdered complete strangers at a steady pace without any sign of stopping. Statistically, women had been known to murder only their partners, lovers, or people who were in their care, and were usually not motivated by sexual or psychological gratification like male killers were. But Aileen had always been one of the boys, and would find herself ranked amongst the worst of them in America. Dubbed the Damsel of Death, the Florida Highway Killer, and the Highway Hooker, she became a source of inspiration for several books, movies, songs, and other works of art, including an opera, and even motivated some feminists to confront the violence that women face every day, particularly in the sex industry. In January 2011, Phyllis Chesler, a feminist leader, wrote, "As the so-called first female serial killer, you've made headlines, not for what has been done to you, but for what you've done. Your bullets shattered the silence about violence against prostituted women, about prostitutes fighting back, and about a prostitute's revenge. No small feat." Rarely, if ever, has a serial killer been portrayed as both a villain and a hero at the same time, and seldom have they been empathized with as much. Aileen had a tough life and was a deeply traumatized and dysfunctional person, but aren't all serial killers? Perhaps the sincerest form of empathy that we all have for her was that on top of all of her abuse and everything she got up to, she was also mostly homeless. When we think of 15-year-old Aileen standing on the side of the road after a night of sleeping in the snow, her frostbitten thumb glistening in the morning light, hoping that someone would give her a ride so that she could sell herself for a warm shower or a small meal, we inevitably feel sorry for her. And if things had stayed that way, our pity would be valid. However, in this book you will learn that as much as she tried to portray herself as a reasonable, well-intended victim of abuse, with a softer, smaller voice than one might have initially imagined based on the way she conducted herself, Aileen was a felon, with an expansive rap sheet, a violent temper, and an inflated ego, which she used to her advantage in every situation. She had physically assaulted several men, committed armed robbery, stolen cars and possessions, and spent time in prison before she graduated as a serial killer in her criminal career. Her alcohol addiction, manipulative personality, and all the quick fixes that she had come up with to get cash in her hands as fast as possible, ultimately led her to the execution chamber, where, still then, she threatened the world with the delusions that her mind had been holding onto as a coping mechanism. Perhaps the quality that many people can give her credit for, despite her terrible circumstances throughout her life, was her courage. Aileen was fiercely courageous, deeply determined, and had admirable resilience. In her letters, she wrote, "I'm like a marine. You can't hurt me. If you hurt me, I can wipe it out of my mind and keep on trucking." While we have all at some point speculated about why she murdered, it seems most plausible that she wiped out anyone who challenged her worth or who withheld money. That is what set off her uncontrollable rage and left her beating, bruising, and eventually shooting those scumbags, as she liked to say. When she realized that she had gotten away with it, gained the things she needed to make her girlfriend happy, and was for once not abandoned or neglected, she put that cycle on repeat and would never have stopped if she were not caught. Her crimes, while quite chaotic and disorganized, certainly had an element of premeditation, where she carefully chose isolated locations up to 100 miles apart to carry out her intentions, which was to rob and murder unsuspecting loners. Once they had been stripped of their cash, cars, and personal belongings, she either pawned the items off or gave it to her girlfriend. Something that Bundy also liked to do with his trophies. In an interview, Aileen was asked if she felt remorse and if she would consider apologizing to the family members of her victims. In response, she said that she was sorry that her victims were all sexually defunct and deranged, that their families were not innocent, and that their sexual depravity is what got them killed. Much like Gacy, Aileen was a professional at shifting the blame. The difference in her case compared to other prolific serial killers was that she got the maximum sentence without ever having the option of a life sentence. Even Ted Bundy was given the option of a life sentence, as was Dahmer, Kemper, Ridgway, Rader, and many more. It was almost as if Aileen served as an example to other women for what would happen if they followed in her footsteps. Despite it all, she was an unforgettable gal. She loved to say gal, royal, and to the max, who will forever garner sympathy from onlookers, even decades beyond her time on Earth, where she trudged along the highways of the USA, thirsty for a Budweiser. How did she become so famous, and why did so many people want a little piece of the pie? Let's investigate. Part 1. Case Facts. Capture. Between November 1989 and November 1990, the police discovered the bodies of 6 men who had all been murdered in the same way. Shot, seemingly robbed, and left in the dust of their stolen car in most cases. While a 7th victim's body was never found, the crime scene was the same, with the addition of a smudgy palm print on the interior of the abandoned car, and a few strands of blonde hair on the seat. There was clearly a pattern, and suspicion grew that the murders were committed by a serial killer in the area. All victims were white, middle-aged men from low to middle-income backgrounds who were traveling alone on the highways in Florida. Never had it entered the investigators' minds that the murders were committed by one woman by herself. At that point, they were toying with the idea of a killer couple, a female accomplice of a male serial killer, or a variety of crimes committed by various people that just seemed to fit a pattern. That is, until they scanned the palm print and fingerprints found in the car, which brought up the picture of a female with a criminal history, Miss Aileen Carol Lee Wuornos, a 5'4", 162 cm, 137 lb, 62 kg woman who had frequent run-ins with the law in the years leading up to these crimes. She had previously been arrested for driving under the influence, DUIs, disorderly conduct.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.